Hi, I'm Dr. Joseph Horzempa, and I'm the interim chair of the Department of Biological Sciences here at West Liberty University. I'm also a microbiology professor, and I specialize in infectious disease research. Here are some common questions about COVID-19. So what is COVID-19? COVID-19 is the disease caused by the novel coronavirus, which is known as SARS-CoV-2. COVID-19 stands for coronavirus disease, and then the 19 is the year that the outbreak began, 2019. So what is the university's policy on masks? Our policy here at West Liberty University is that masks need to be worn in all buildings on campus, except for whenever faculty and staff are in their offices by themselves. They can take the mask off. When students who are living on campus return to their dorm rooms, they can take the mask off. But when you're in a building on campus, mask wearing is mandatory. So what if I'm outside? The mask policy outdoors is that masks do not need to be worn when you can maintain proper social distance. However, when you are getting closer to other people, you should put the mask on outside as well. Are masks effective at reducing the spread of coronavirus? And is there any evidence to suggest that wearing a mask is effective in reducing the spread or transmission of the coronavirus? So I always tell my students, trust the data. And there's lots of data, lots of evidence out there suggesting that wearing a mask is actually very effective at reducing the risk of transmission of the coronavirus. Here's how it works. When we breathe, talk, sing, cough, sneeze, we exhale droplets and aerosols. These droplets are what the coronavirus uses to spread from person to person. A mask acts like sort of a speed bump that slows the velocity or the speed of the droplets that come out of the user's mouth. If those droplets move more slowly, then they won't travel as far. And so that means the chances of infecting a person who's maintaining their social distance is reduced. Who does the mask protect? A common misconception is that wearing the mask is going to protect me from getting infected from the coronavirus. But actually, these masks are to protect everyone else. So if I'm an asymptomatic carrier, meaning I have coronavirus and I don't know that I'm infected, if I wear this mask, that's going to help to protect everyone else in the room or everyone else who's around me from picking up the virus, from becoming infected with the virus. Are some masks better than others at preventing the spread of coronavirus? So to demonstrate this, I'm gonna steal a little idea that I got from Bill Nye. So he did this sort of blowing out the candle demonstration. So just for a moment, I'm gonna remove this mask and, you know, blow out the candle. I was able to produce enough velocity with my breath to blow out that candle. And if I were infected with coronavirus, that breath could have carried aerosols to spread throughout the room and potentially infect other people. Now, when I'm wearing a mask like this one, like a surgical mask, blowing very, very hard at the candle, and the candle's not going out. So let's try some other masks. And so now I'm going to try to blow out the candle with this. You can see it's flickering, but it's not going out, but much more air is coming through. Try this mask that my son uses when he plays Nerf guns. It's got an intimidating skull on the front of it. It's like one of those face socks. Blew the candle right out. So the lighter weight materials that, you know, have large spaces between the threads are not as effective as some of these, you know, surgical masks or multiple layers of a mask. Let's look at this N95. Nothing's coming out, right? So very little velocity to blow out the candle. So what is the proper way to wear a mask? So if you have one of these disposable masks, you simply grab the ear straps, put them over your ears, and then you can adjust the nose piece and the chin part, and you're good to go. Right, so you want to make sure that your nose is covered and your mouth is covered, right? You might have seen people wearing masks. I call this the chin mask, like this, walking around. This is not effective. You do not want to wear the mask like this. Can masks harm the person that's wearing them? Masks do not cause hypoxemia or low blood oxygen. However, if you wear a mask over and over without washing it, it can cause acne. So it's recommended that masks are washed, cloth masks are washed after each wear, or if you have a disposable mask like this, you wear it once and then dispose of it. So why should we practice social distancing, and why is 6 feet of distance recommended So the 6 feet recommendation comes from studies done in the 1930s by William Wells, who is a Harvard researcher who studied tuberculosis and how droplets traveled during talking, coughing, sneezing, etc. And Wells' study showed that the droplets that contained the infectious tuberculosis bacterium traveled about 3 to 6 feet during those processes. More recent studies have shown that small droplets produced during an unmasked sneeze can actually travel 8 meters, or almost 27 feet. So in general, the farther we can be apart from one another in a room, the better. The 6 feet is a minimum. Is wearing a mask an alternative to social distancing? No. Wearing a mask is not an alternative to social distancing. The two work together. As you've seen from the simulations, wearing the mask helps to slow those particles, those droplets, to come out of our mouth. So if we stand the proper distance apart, there's a lesser likelihood of any infectious material coming into contact with our neighboring student, faculty, or staff. So I've heard hand washing is important for fighting COVID-19. How long should I wash my hands? Well, you should wash your hands for about 20 seconds, or the amount of time that it would take you to sing Happy Birthday twice. You want to use soap, water, and get a good lather. And you should lather for the 20 seconds. And then rinse. So what happens if a Hilltopper tests positive for COVID-19? So if a student tests positive for coronavirus, they would need to be isolated for 14 days. Typically, that student would be sent home to isolate, or that we have some isolation rooms on campus for students that are unable to travel home. If the symptoms subside after the 14-day period, then that student is able to return to class and other activities. What should I do if I think I have COVID-19? The first thing for the student to do would be to call Student Health Services, and you'll be counseled over the phone or have a Zoom appointment scheduled. The healthcare professional, Christy Bennington, the Director of Student Health Services, will provide advice on the next steps, which may include getting tested. If it's off hours, it's recommended that you go to doctor's urgent care. So a common comment about the coronavirus is that people ask, isn't this just like the flu? And while both the virus that causes COVID-19 and the flu virus, influenza virus, are both respiratory viruses, they're completely different biologically. In addition, they have much different mortality rates associated with the different infections. For example, last year in the United States, the influenza virus exhibited a mortality rate of about 0.1%, meaning that one in every 1,000 people who was infected with the flu died as a result of this disease or complications associated with the flu. This year in the United States, with the SARS-CoV-2 virus, or COVID-19, this disease shows a mortality rate of 3.75%, which means that the SARS-CoV-2 virus is about 37 to 40 times more deadly than the influenza virus. So no, they're not the same thing. So where can I find credible information? You can find reliable information at cdc.gov, at the West Liberty University coronavirus page, or by clicking the links provided in the description on the efficacy of wearing masks. So I hope this video cleared some things up about COVID-19 and about masks, and we're all looking forward to seeing you in the fall semester.